This video has been sponsored by the website www.isoclassifieds.com.
As far as the salary is concerned, I won't take even $1. I am totally giving up my salary.
Sorry, Mr. President-elect Trump. It does not work that way. According to the U.S. Constitution, Article 1, Section 9, President-elect Trump must choose. Does he want to be president, remain a billionaire, or let Congress decide?
This is Gabby Ray Talker reporting in front of the White House here in reviewing Constitution. So, as it stands, President-elect Trump must be transitioned into compliance with the U.S. Constitution as president. According to Article 1, Section 9, there's an emolument clause, which means that he as president should not be receiving profits of any kind if it's not approved by Congress. According to an article at dailycause.com and a news report at CNN, it states that Richard Painter, previous White House ethics counselor for George W. Bush, and Norman Eisen, White House ambassador and previous ethics counselor for Barack Obama, these two lawyers believe that if Trump continues to retain ownership over his sprawling business interests, by the time the electors meet on December 19th, they should reject Trump. However, if Trump is approved for presidency on the Electoral College meeting day, and if he is found still receiving emoluments from foreign powers other than the U.S. government, he may be impeached. But if he is not impeached, he may be displaced at the end of the 4 years. This provision was specifically created to prevent the president, most of all, from being corrupted by foreign influences that could distract him from providing his undivided full-time attention as president. Barack Obama's White House ambassador and previous ethics counselor Norman Eisen said that the electors should insist that Trump set up a blind trust for all as a condition for getting votes by the Electoral College on December 19th. Also, the previous ethics counselor for George W. Bush, Richard Painter, has recommended in a CNN report for Trump to sign over all of his payments over to the U.S. government, followed by an audit of confirmation that he may avoid being in violation of the U.S. Constitution. So now it appears that the only thing that would stop Donald Trump from going on to the presidency seat is Donald Trump. Aside from the Electoral College, of course, who would make the final decision. But at this point, there's only a few things on the table that opposing parties against Trump are using in hopes that he would be rejected for presidency, but will they succeed? For example, there's a petition on change.org for Hillary Clinton, and it argues that Donald Trump is unfit to serve and that Secretary Clinton won the popular vote and should be president. According to the Constitution, it is possible for the Electoral College to elect Hillary Clinton on December 19th. But according to the experts, they say it will not happen. If you ask me, I think she gave up too fast. She conceded the very next morning after the election night, and she didn't even challenge the results, just the same as Trump said he would have challenged the results, and that is if he lost. But in Hillary Clinton's case, she gave up so quickly, but why? So I had to investigate the situation, and I came up with a possible answer. According to TheHill.com, three of Clinton's sources disclosed to a couple of writers that President Barack Obama urged Hillary Clinton to concede on elections night. The writers are Amy Parnes and Jonathan Allen, who are working on a book about Clinton's defeat. They reveal shocking details of the alleged conversation that took place between Clinton and Obama that election night. They stated that Obama called Clinton to persuade her to concede by saying, "You need to concede," while she still waited for the results from three states, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania. By early morning Wednesday, Clinton followed the advice of Obama, and without knowing the full results, she called Trump to acknowledge her defeat. Fortunately enough for Hillary Clinton, it may not be a defeat. Green Party presidential nominee Jill Stein has stepped up with over $5 million of donated funds she has raised in order to get a recount of the votes in three states, Michigan, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania. She stated that there may have been voter fraud in these three states. She realizes that the voting results will not change for herself, who received less than 2% of the votes. It may not change for Hillary Clinton either. However, Stein is making an effort with the recount request to ensure the integrity of the election. The Green Party nominee expressed that the recount is positive. It will confirm that the system can be trusted. On the other hand, the Obama administration viewed the act of challenging the voting system as unnecessary. On November 26, 2016, the New York Times cited the Obama administration as stating, "We stand behind our election results, which accurately reflect the will of the American people." Now, if the recount shows that all three states were miscounted, it would open up a huge can of worms. But before I speak on that, I would like to know the results first. Either way, on December 19th, the Electoral College will have major issues to decide on, like, one, as stated in the beginning, will Trump choose between being the president, remaining a billionaire, or letting the Electoral College decide based on the emolument clause in the U.S. Constitution? Number two, will the Electoral College honor the petition for Hillary Clinton to be president based on the fact that she received the popular vote? Number three, will the Electoral College consider Jill Stein recount if there are any significant findings? As it stands, everything is up in the air. We cannot be sure who the president will be based on all of the findings that are emerging. Hopefully, by or after December 19th, we will have a clearer picture of who will be sitting in the presidential seat by January 2017. This is Gabby Ray Talker. Come check me out on my social networks and come see me at www.isoclassifieds.com, where you can post ads and video ads for free. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.